Our guest on this episode of the podcast is Ndumi Hadebe, a self-leadership coach. She's published a book, Handle Black Tax Like a Pro, Setting Boundaries, Improving Relationships, and Achieving Freedom. And this is a book about how to strike a healthy balance between helping family or relatives while allowing space for personal financial goals through the practice of healthy boundaries. She's got more than a decade of corporate experience and another decade as an entrepreneur consulting as a development expert. And she's our guest on this episode of the podcast. My name is Nongcebo Vukile McKenzie. Welcome, ngiyakwamukela, to the podcast. On today's episode of the podcast, we are speaking to Ndumi Hadebe. She's a self-leadership coach and she's written a book, a very relatable book, entitled Handle Black Tax Like a Pro. Ndumi, welcome to the podcast.
Thank you, Nongcebo. Thanks for the invitation.
Handle Black Tax Like a Pro, Setting Boundaries, Improving Relationships, and Achieving Freedom. That's the full title of the book. I introduced it as Handle Black Tax Like a Pro, but the full title is Handle Black Tax Like a Pro, Setting Boundaries, Improving Relationships, and Achieving Freedom. I'm curious about that second half, the setting boundaries half.
Yeah. Well, that's basically the intervention that I'm proposing as means to handle black tax like a pro, right? Because I acknowledge the fact that most of us have inherited this thing called black tax, responsibility tax, family tax, whatever the term a person prefers to use there. But the reality remains, ukuthi, how we manage it determines how our finances look like in future, you know, when we are 50, 60, 70, 80, or whatever. So, in most people want to know, should I do it? Should I not do it? And I'm simply saying, set boundaries. Do what is within your means based on what your needs, your wants, your thoughts and feelings are around that particular issue or around, at that, you know, around that specific time. So, setting boundaries is, in my view, the departure point of any progress or any goal that we want to achieve in actual fact.
So you are a self-leadership coach, and the stance that you've taken with the book, or the angle that you've taken with the book, is to share stories, basically case studies, of people who are facing these situations and guiding, based on those stories, how the situation could have been managed differently to the benefit of the person who is finding themselves in that situation of paying black tax. So now, some people say even calling it tax is wrong. They say it's ukhombisa ubuntu bokuthi ukhulisiwe ubunekhaya ba sacrifice laba bakukhulisile ngabo gogo ngaba bazali ngabo aunti laba bakukhulisile ukuthi ke nawe ukhombisa ukuthi bona bebetshala kuwena nawe akube khona okubuyiselayo kungathi ngoba nakho wena usuphumelele hayi phapha usuyandiza usuyaphephuka usuyabashiya awusabheki nasemuva. So some people say no, it's not tax, it's just giving back to the people that, you know, got me to where I am.
And in Yavumelana Nab, that is why the boundaries are a factor here, because the boundaries will determine how much a person actually gives back, right? How much money is allocated to giving back. The point about boundaries is to say to people, getting into debt to facilitate black tax request or family responsibility request is counterintuitive. I basizi about if family yako long term, I see wena, I see the ingane zako in future, right? So the term black tax, it is because it feels like it is it's compulsory for most people. But like I said, it's a placeholder. A person can use whatever terminology they want to use there. Handle family tax like a pro. Handle black tax like a pro. Handle responsibility like a pro. The point is about the navigating of it. The name becomes almost neither here nor there when you are doing it efficiently. So that is why I find myself not necessarily wanting to negate when a person says, oh no, but it's not black tax.
Mm-hmm.
I agree. It's not, it shouldn't be a tax.
Mm-hmm.
But the reality is that for most people, it does feel like a tax, because in a sense of entitlement, in a sense of what is compulsory, and more often than not, during the research of this book, people have told me their opinions on the matter of how much they are giving is not considered sometimes by their loved ones. So that makes it feel compulsory. Therefore, the term tax becomes applicable.
I remember speaking to somebody else who had written another piece on black tax, and I was presenting the perspective that ukulekelela kubalulekile. Uma kuwukuthi amandla unawo kubalulekile. Kodwa my position was, if bekuthanda bekucabangela nabo abazukufuna ukuthi uze nawe uzithole manje usuvele ngonwele ey'kweletini, awusakwazi nanokuphefumula, awusakwazi nanokuthini, awusakwazi nanokuthini. And he was saying that his departure point is that as a black person, you just must. And I was like, you must? Really? And I was like, yeah, you must. It's something that you just must. As a personal standpoint, he was presenting the perspective that yena ngokwakhe i-black tax akufanele kube yinto mhlawumbe esingabonisana ngayo, siphikisane ngayo, kulokho kuboniswana ukuthi hayi kanti bakithi kuyoze kube nini, nabantu fanele kube what. No, kufanele, kufanele nje ungalokhu ushona le nale, kufanele yinto as umuntu ekufanele uyenze ukukhombisa ukuthi umuntu. So that I found very interesting in the context of what you are saying now, that that's where then it start feeling taxi, because the minute you say it's a matter of must, that's where it starts feeling taxi. Because
absolutely it goes back to the question that Unikim Shongo asked in his book in 2019, whether it's a burden or Ubuntu, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that question was relevant 5-6 years ago. We needed to have asked that.
Mm-hmm.
But going back to what the person that you are talking about is saying, that it is a must, I'm saying I disagree fully with that, because this is what's keeping black people in debt. This is why people will go and get a loan of 100,000 rand to renovate their main family home and take 3-4 years to repay that loan. And that loan, when they pay back, it's 300,000. How is that healthy for the individual who took the loan? How is it healthy for umdin walomuntu who took the loan? The point that I'm trying to make again and again throughout the book is for people to see that it is dysfunctional and toxic to pour from a place that is empty, you know, to get into situations that you cannot afford, because it means subconsciously abantu ba assume ukuthi izingane zabo will be there to take care of them in the future.
It perpetuates it.
The kids that we are raising might not be here when you and I are 70, 80. Baba fundi ma private schools, ba exposed. The world has become smaller. So our kids are not a retirement plan. We need to think about our own retirement, manje.
Mm-hmm.
And that means we must navigate our finances proactively, including irresponsibility and black tax.
But also, does it not perpetuate it though, Ndumi? Because let's say somebody's child is not going to a private school and is not necessarily privileged, right? But umzali wakhe is sacrificing everything ukulungisa emuva. Again, not saying ukulungisa emuva go wrong, but as you are saying, as you're highlighting in the book, ukuthi fanele kwenzeke within reasonable means. Lowo mntwana ukuze naye ngoba the time ikulungiswa emuva khona okusilelayo la esikhona njengamanje, okusho ukuthi ke lokho
which means we are not, so abantu bathi but what about paying it forward, and I'm saying That's exactly it. When you are not giving your children a better life than mm-hmm. the one that you had, you are not paying it forward as a parent.
Mm-hmm.
Right? It means you are not giving your child the best possible chances of success in life mm-hmm. because usebenzela, you are investing backwards.
So,
as opposed to forwards.
So something that's very effective in making black tax happen is emotional blackmail, right? It's a very, very effective tool. So you will find that whoever it may be, and I'll make an example that's not even related. Ukubone ukuthi uma usukhulile, usunemoto, uvakasha, uya ekhaya, kuthiwe hamba olifta umama usibani bani uye esontweni. Mhlawumbe esontweni is like 15 kilometers away. To hamba uyomlift. No, awumlift, uyamhambisa. It's a difference. Exactly. Like usuke ekhaya umhambisa, uyamhambisa, and then kufanele ubuye umlande. Uma usumlande afanele abuye adlule somewhere. Now there's siyingane kubazali bethu. So kufanele sithumeke ngiphikisani nalokho. Kodwa uthola ukuthi kuzothi yazi nje ngikhumbula una 3 months ngangingazi nanokuthi uzobanjwa ubani. Umama umasikhakhane nje uyena owangisiza. Lapho manje ugijima lapha ko-40 something. Kodwa every time ubuyile uze ekhaya kufanele uhambise umama umasibanibani because, you know, and these are the things, that's a very light, very non-consequential, you know, example that, you know, these are the things that you do because umzali wakho has got a special place in, or rather has a special place for that person in their heart because wayemlekelelile ngaleyo ndlela kubalulekile kuyena kwasho lukhulu kuyena. But what we find is that when it comes to whoever it is that has certain expectations of us, ukuthi kufanele ungenzele ukuthi, uthola ukuthi uzosebenzisa lezi zinto. Okokuqala, ngangehla ngenyuka. Okokuqala, ngalahlwa usibanibani. Okokuqala, ngikhulelwe iy'nyawo zami zazingaka. Okokuqala, kwenzeka ukuthi nokuthi ukhule nawe unento. Le nto futhi ayiqali phela masomdala ngithi. Ngesikhathi ukukhula, ukukhula unesense yokuthi, hey, wahlupheka lo muntu ngokuthi ngibe khona emhlabeni. Hey, futhi ukuba ngangingekho impilo yakhe ngabe yangco yabangcono. Your mind does not say that, but that's the sense of, should I say, sympathy or that place of
subconsciously.
Yeah, where you then say, you start feeling when if uphila kahle, it's almost like you don't deserve it. Ukuthi uphile kahle because yena, this person suffered because of you. And that's how you are then able to just keep on giving and keep on giving and keep on giving. Because ucabanga ukuthi lo muntu wangikhulisa ngaze ngaqeda esikolweni, ngahamba ngaye e-university, ngaye e-tech, ngaqala ngasebenza, or whatsoever that it is, the path that you followed. Ubona ukuthi, hey, for this amount of time, 22 years, this person had it so hard because of me. So now for the next 22 years, namfane ngiyifile ipinch. I'm not in any way a psychologist, but I'm wondering if that's what plays on it and makes it easier.
So emotional blackmail, it's a double-edged sword in a sense. So like you said, it starts from the beginning when you hear these nuances, and so on, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the issue with that is that ngathi wena wafika lana wazo wabo umthwalo walaba bantu who brought you onto this earth.
Mm-hmm.
So that comes with a sense of guilt and shame by itself. Before nje kufika imali, before kube khona anything. And then there is the piece that is then ukuthi you must show your appreciation.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So it's almost like that's a repayment.
Mm-hmm.
And in the wanting to show your appreciation for the things that your parents have done for you, kube in a sense of abantu going beyond reasoning or going beyond calculation, going beyond logic. Of course, ngiyakuzwa uma kuthi fanele ngiyomlanda umama usikhakhane kuphi kuphi kodwa phela manje uyabona ukuthi seku 45 minutes away from la ngikhona and masibala isikhathi ngiya ngibala isikhathi ngibuya blana la kusafanele ngiye khona then kuba a bit difficult singa ayike indlela esingenza ngayo uyabona so asisafiki nakula uma options ngobani sifila this pressure of wanting to jabulisa umzali sisama ukususa lesa silonda sokuthi umzali wathola kanzima khathi sikhulisa and as much as that's not your fault as a child, it's not the, probably it's not even their fault because our situations at the time, our society could not participate fully with mainstream economy. So, in situation they didn't put themselves there.
Mm-hmm.
We just have to recognize that for what it is.
Mm-hmm.
But we have the capacity to hold this truth at the same time
mm-hmm.
by educating abazali bethu. Bahlalise phansi nje, umuntu umchazisele nje ukuthi mina ma makukanje kukanje ngicela sinavigate kanje kanje kancane kancane singazi ngamawala slowly but surely because masibheka from lokuthi hey uma uyang blackmail maximum accuser manje umzali or that she's going out of the way uyenza into ngamasibomo thina who are more exposed more educated and well averse ngalama issues that has to take the responsibility of leading the family in the journey of healing through these type of issues siyenze with love and compassion and I do believe it's possible.
So from the stories that you've collected in the book, the 10 stories that you've collected in the book, one of the things that you identified is vezo abantu inxoxe nabo is the more I do, the more I'm expected to do, right? And I always find that interesting, just generally with human beings. It's like, umuntu maye nice teen, generally. Lo muntu sibona ukuthi singenza noma yini ngoba useke wangixolela. Asibuki ukuthi ayibo uxolo phela linomkhawulo uma seke wangixolela umuntu angingaphinde ngimgcobe lolo xolwa ngiliphathise kweyikhali zamantungwa ukuze ngingaphindi ngiyithole sethi hayi phela ngaxolela mfo ngeke ngiphinde lokho ngidlala wena kunalokho umuntu uma eke waxolela angazi ukuthi I don't know what it is about human beings and I suppose you know this is not to say it in a judgmental way it's just a way that things tend to happen and I gather that this would be the same thing with the more I do the more I'm expected to do because ngempela kuze kubukeke sengathi uma ukhiphe u 500 rand look understanding that 500 rand doesn't go very far in today's economy uma ukhiphe u 500 rand uma unganelanga akuthatheki sengathi lo 500 rand nawe bekuwo wokugcina kuthatheka sengathi bekufanele ngabe mhlawumbe uthe ukuthasisela mhlawumbe wakhipha u 750 ukuze kuthi ukuba ngcobangcolwana ayifiki into yokuthi kushuthi nayo bengenawo nkosi yami u 250 ukuthi engeze amandla akhe aphelele kulo 500 into ithi manje bhuti kona sikwazile ukuthi sicoshe kodwa nje mhlawumbe mangase ubhuti mhlawumbe athi kusifakele enye inkosi yami sikwazi ukuthi sibambabambe kungacabange ukuthi mhlawumbe nawe uqonqothe eyokugcina mhlawumbe nawe usalunge nayo imali yokugibela ukuze ukhiphe le mali from your engagement and your discussions and your research what is it that leads people to believe more ingoba mhlawumbe kuthiwa umuntu uhlala ko Goli ko Mathekwini ko maphi maphi is that it
so ngiyalapho so that's one of the things Nongcebo that's asibeke iqiniso to a certain degree before sifike ukuthi the more we do the more we are expected to do nathi we portray the look and feel yokuthi siya afford ukwenza more
okay
and we do not afford our parents asibanikezi ithuba lokuthi sibachazisele ukuthi kahle izikweletu engikuzona I am drowning perhaps or ama goals ami ahamba aqine lana so kuzomele ngi o abheke la ama goals ami so kuzomele mina ngi save kangaka maybe I need to save so mina in a case of me being self employed I have to save at least 15% of my income right because my income is unpredictable now whose responsibility is it to explain that to my parents or my loved ones or beneficiaries of my responsibility tax or black tax it is me so what I found with people when engaging them is that they don't have asiyenzi conversation with abazali bethu about about this money that we are paying every month. It's just an elephant in the room.
Mm-hmm.
Yet, ama stop orders, nama SMSs, nama e-wallets, aya popa every week, every month.
Mm-hmm.
But it's an elephant in the room. So, asi kulumi.
Mm-hmm.
Number two is that people have atmosphere. Mangiti fear. Ngisho lolia, undi mangabe nithi sithi during a coaching session, akazame nje, we introduce a topic, kubo or kubabu wake or kuma wake. Men cry. I have had coached someone who 2 years ago, the thought of going home gave inkosikazi yakhe a mild stroke. The thought of going home go December kuma in-laws gave the wife a mild stroke. Why? Because there isn't room to negotiate.
Mm-hmm.
You do as I say as umzal in this particular case,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
But the third and the most important thing is that Tina, human beings,
mm-hmm.
we like being liked.
Mm-hmm.
So much that we don't set the boundary because we have the fear that it will jeopardize the relationship. So it's in the not stating the fear, the boundary,
mm-hmm.
where we then get abused. Because I get kumunto zoti, hai, nungzebo, yazi, kota o, sing, njomu sisoko mnani, ngazi, siya kabi njile lingi kshuku meza ngayo, kitele manje simu falu mpo mbibanda yu, kwa limali yako. Nobody. You have to be the one that has the courage to say, okay, ama goals ga nungzebo, ami ganje. How I feel about financial freedom is 1, 2, 3. My needs are 1, 2, 3. Then you look at it and you're saying, so in the past 10 years, I've been going about this the wrong way. Ngivele ngenze mhlamba ma ngivumela ma request abe random. Maybe a new way of going about it would be to saying, let me have a specific family responsibility item within my budget and communicate that up front so that people know ukuthi unomvelo uhamba gcine la. Hayi ngoba khona umuntu omzondayo ngoba mhlambe usufunge Dubai uyomusha imali. No, because you are clear on what it is that you want for you and your goals, because also you know ukuthi i-retirement iyezaphela.
But Ndumi, how can I have goals? How can I have any desire to go on any form of holiday? How can I have any desire to have any form of unnecessary, in parenthesis, unnecessary thing? Kube udadewethu engafundi, kube ingane kadadewethu ongasebenzi ingenayo imali yokuregister, kube ingane kamzala kamana abakhula naye wamlekelele imweni einzima, okwathi uma ehlwelwe ndawo thizeni weza wazomlanda wamsiza manje ingane yakhe ixakekile. How can I even begin to justify, or how can I even begin to expect that I deserve any good? Kukhona umuntu owenza into enkulu kangaka noma obaluleke kangaka ukuthi yena khona kuswele.
So we deserve and you good regardless of what's going on,
mm-hmm.
in and around you. You are just deserving of the things that you want, of the goodness. So let's maybe remove a holiday because it looks ngathi it's luxurious, mm-hmm. right? Which actually, as I get older, I realize traveling is so unsexy. A destination yon imnandi, but figurecon can just be so a little bit
laborious,
too intense. Yeah, it's just that big word. But the point that I'm trying to make is, let's make an example about something as important as my business.
Mm-hmm.
I am running a business.
Mm-hmm.
Money comes in from a client. The client pays. I need to pay for resources to enable this business.
Mm-hmm.
That's what needs to be a priority. Because if lady business lam linga cool, lo cousin okuluma ngaye, lo bani onga registile, no o makhelwane.
Mm-hmm.
Angikwazi ukubasiza if leli business liwile lati bu because ngijahe ukusiza abantu. Yebon?
Mm-hmm.
So the starting point is that let the individual have a certain level of self-sufficiency, because it is scientifically impossible ukuthi umuntu kungani ukuthi wena Nongcebo uzokwazi ukunikeza amanzi iglass yakho iempty iqedwe yimina futhi sengiyabuya mina ngizofuna futhi amanzi from you, but I'm the one that finished the water, right? So it might be a good thing for us to consider ukuthi let me allow Nongcebo as my sister to accumulate sufficient water ukuze akwazi ukuthi ngalamanzi akhe acobelele mina azibekele naye wakhe ophuze. So abantu abaningi bayibheka njalo from a immediate gratification into yakhona.
Mm.
And the people that I've interviewed post writing the book who are not paying black tax, their parents delayed gratification.
Mm-hmm.
Their parents saved. Their parents invested. Their parents did not rush to move into suburbs. Their parents did not rush to taking early retirement. They delayed gratification or benefits of having imali at some point.
Mm-hmm.
They delayed clothes. They delayed things, right?
Mm-hmm.
So there might be things that we, as this generation, have to delay.
Mm-hmm.
So that we have the capacity to manage this responsibility, because we are the first generation that kind of has it all, if you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
We are the first generation to have access to advancement ka corporate. We are the first generation to be able to do our podcasts, the freedom, right now,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
Really, truly, the world is our oyster. We can make money on the internet. We can make money. Somebody in India bought an online course, they are condoming. Ding, ding, signal in the bank account. Things that were inconceivable for abazali bethu. That said, we are also the sandwich generation. Ngoba, we abazali bethu. But by is cutting by responsibility yetu. For most
mm-hmm.
people, our parents are our responsibility.
Mm-hmm.
We are our own responsibility. The things that abazali bethu could not give us,
mm-hmm.
we are trying to give those things to ourselves.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We are cycling, we are playing golf. See, travel, since I often do the thing that our parents couldn't give us. And also, we are doing our best to give our kids the best or better than what our parents gave us.
Mm-hmm.
So the pressure is on. It's not dual, it's triple.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So it means that our level of efficiency in managing these responsibilities has to be elevated.
Mm-hmm.
We cannot do it the same way that our parents did it, because their circumstances are being a fan now. We are one. So, and mina now inganze ukuthi no mina mami ngicela ukufunda e New York. Yabona? Tina, misfunda UKZN, sfunda UCT. You've arrived, mufunda UCT. Our kids today want more,
mm-hmm.
right? Which means we ought to do more. So how are we going to do all of those things if we are using ama techniques or pasa umetric whilst we are facing EMBA level of complexity?
So how do we pass on these lessons to our children? When I say pass on these lessons, the interconnectedness that comes with still being part of your family, still engaging with your family, still, you know, the whole broader, bigger family context means although kukhona ama challenges nama responsibilities aba added, where it's functional, it also means you've got added support for various things. And
yes,
when we then move siyohlala komagoli, komathekwini, komapesheya, the circle becomes smaller. But also the reality is that when you do take these decisions, when you do say, bakwethu, ngiyazi ukuthi nenza umsebenzi, ngiyazi ukuthi lo msebenzi ubalekile kodwa angi afford njengamanje mangibheka izinto engifuna ukuzenza angi afford ukuthi ngithathe i trip ezodinga ukuthi ngi drive ngibe no petrol or diesel ukuthi ngize lapho it's a 6-hour drive ngibe na accommodation ngi contribute ngibuye ngi drive back leyo mali angi afford leyo nto ke iyinto embi kabi kabi akezanga emsebenzini kagogo akenzanga ayinhle neze ndume ayinhle ngisho ungayichaza uthini ngisho ngathi hayi kukhona okungibambile or angiphilile kuba khona into egadayo ukuthi olandelayo umcimbi noma okasibanibani okamalume okay wavela kuona kungani le nto yakususela nje ukukhuluma kanti lapho wena ugade into yakho yemali mhlawumbe uzungalibeki nangembaba ukuthi hayi ngigade imali ukuze kungabi kungathiwa ave inqonqela uNongcebo kube ukuthi nje uqhamuka uyabona nje ubika izabu ubika ukuthi nje hayi manje ukuthi kwathini kwangathangani ukuze ugweme na ukwazi ukuthi uzicontrol ngokweyimali leyo nto ke isi thini ke manje isithi abantwana bakho abasakhuli in that same sense right that you had of the extended family the cousins the everybody that exceeding to these requests affords you umuhle ngophela umuhle ngemali awuvela ube muhle nje emdenini ube muhle nje ngokuthi ubuhle cha and when you stop doing those things kuba nalowo umthelela wokuthi okay then they then lose out on this other aspect now losing out on that other aspect also means that they lose out on some of the lessons so we say our kids are growing up differently they're more individualistic they're more they are more western in terms of how they approach the family because remember abanye abantwana bayabuka abazali babo be sacrifice lento imcasula umntwana ithi uma noma ubaba even if ukuthi mhlambe that doesn't leave them out of pocket I mean I've got a friend of mine it doesn't leave him out of pocket he can afford to do the things that he wants to do for his family and he wants to do them and he does it you know generously and willingly but his son looks at it and says I see the stress that my father goes through trying to manage all of this I see how ungracious people are and I see how ungrateful people are and I am actually resentful of what my father experiences ubaba kwenza akumlimaza kumhlupha kumhlukumezi uyathanda ukwenza kodwa I feel that the people that he does this for it's an opportunity my father's putting you through school then appreciate that don't go and wenza izinto ezirongo my father's buying this for you to start your business then musa kwenza izinto ezirongo and because of labo bantu bengakuhloniphi lokho abakwenzelwa ubaba wakhe he is starting to step back from the family because he's resentful of what he sees as a lack of appreciation for his father the question is how do we pass the lessons of that interconnectivity to our children because bona lezinto abayibukayo it's either the scenario that I'm describing
it's a beautiful question but it's multi-layered so let me start with the part where we say what do we pass on to our children you know mm-hmm. or what do we teach them you know through this entire dynamic mm-hmm. so the most important thing that I feel our kids need to learn from us mm-hmm. is them seeing us practicing healthy boundaries mm-hmm. in a way that is loving and compassionate mm-hmm. to our loved ones mm-hmm. because that teaches them to do the same thing mm-hmm. either at home at school with friends and in relationships etc mm-hmm. so that's the lesson number 1 mm-hmm. number 2 when they observe us managing you know like how the example that you made with about your friend mm-hmm. who is capable and is willing and yet there's a complexity around but you know do these people deserve mm-hmm. all of this help mm-hmm. You know my dad is always stressed because he's working so hard and so on mm-hmm. so that is an issue of now an issue of transparency mm-hmm. where the parents are supposed to be having open conversations with their children mm-hmm. about what they do and why they do what they do. Give kids context because when kids don't have context, they then make their own conclusions and make their own assumptions and not understand things like, you know, I'm building a legacy about them in 10 years or 20 years time not having a job or not having an education, right? Mm-hmm. So if we had constructive conversation openly with our children they would be far more supportive as opposed to them, but the assumer on their own. And then now it's the issue of Leoguti, maybe the question that around the issue of maybe moving to ahead of the family, you know, maybe being elitist or being perceived as elitist. Mm. And now making our kids be less exposed to maybe the where we come from. Even that, in my view, I believe if we have seen with the generation yet, seen a relationship, a health in abazal bit, we bring her into the equation of the dynamic with okay, Master Jobek is pilaganje, Master Gogo is pilaganje. Tina as a family, sihamba sifikela ukuthi asikwenzi because of 1, 2, 3. Kodwa ke masivakasheka abantu banibani, sizobayekela bona sibavumele benze lokho bona bafuna ukwenza ngendlela yabo. Ngoba vele how families operate, whether Western or African, it's always different, right? So I feel that sometimes the complexity of our issues, it's not that they are complex. It is that we don't discuss them. Asihlali phansi sicubungule ezindeni nje around the table sixoxa kudliwa i-chicken on a Sunday evening ukuthi hawu ubona kanjani ngokuthi nokuthi nokuthi engage nje i-teenager and let the teenager engage you back you know screw ngendlela yabo bakuphikise bakuvumele bakuchallenge and so on. So because nathi asikhuliswanga kanjalo asikwenzi sufficiently with ingane zethu. So ingane zethu siyivalela ngaphandle kuma decisions a key in the running of the family. And I know someone, she's a lecturer and based in the UAE, and uthi ingane zakhe bacacisela ngihola imali engaka, ama expenses ethu mangaka. She's a single mother. And sihamba sifike la esele ingaka, eyegrosa ingaka. Ngoba uma ngabe ngabafundisi, then bazoba stuck kwi-cycle yokunga-understand imali in any case, uma ngabe sebesebenza labo bantu. So the more we involve ingane in this complex, in fact I don't want to say complex, in the conversation yemali and in the conversation of ama-decisions abalulekile within umndeni, iyabasiza babe ne-level of understanding, bangabi naleya judgment ukuthi ya but ubaba wami uyahlukumezeka kwanjani kwanjani. Ithina esiba rob our kids of the opportunity to have this full understanding that can help them grow actually benze baba abantu as opposed to being iy'ngane as the other that are othering other people, you know, abazoba no-us and them, those poor people. Sina si right ekhaya, so labayana si bona ngoba bona baxakekile. No, we must have all of those conversations, including the infamous conversation ye black tax with ingane zethu.
You know, you are really challenging people to have conversations both with their parents and with their children, because as you're saying, if kuguti umntwana wakho ubona uloke ukhipha imali, I mean, as with your parents, as with your friends, as with your partner, as with anyone, umuntu akubona uloke ukhipha imali wazi ukuthi kushuthi unayo, number one. So even with our children, umezo ucela lokhu namhlanje umnikeze, acele lokhu yakusasa umnikeze, acele lokhu yangale, I mean, uphinde umnike futhi. Lo muntu wazi ukuthi hayi kushuthi awunankinga, uyomangala mhlazane wathi cha, futhi mhlawumbe nobambani impela ngalolu langa, akubuze ukuthi unqabelani ngoba uhlezi uvuma. So that goes for across, you know, it's just, you know, what we teach people is what they come to believe is true. But what you're doing is you are challenging also the perception that ubaba uhleze ekhipha imali nomama uhleze ekhipha imali, and therefore laba bantu baxakekile bahlwempu, and therefore thina sincono. Mhlawumbe umzali wakho uyikhipha ngoba wa decide ukuthi yena up until aphelelwa amandla uma wakhe must never have any expense. Umawakhe imali yakhe yempesheni kufanele ayenjoye ayidla amaswiti ngoba umkhulisile wazidecidela yena lokho. But ngoba umntwana wakho wazi ukuthi baphila ngani, kushuthi uzobona ukuthi oh okay, kushuthi ithina uzofika esefuna ukukhomba, efuna ukudemand, efuna ukudictate ngoba vele niphila ngobaba wakhe. So you're challenging us to have those conversations, but you're also challenging us to have conversations with people that we would like to contribute to their well-being, mm-hmm. assist in any way, to say, mm-hmm. I am here, but nami usizo lwami luhamba lugcinela lunomkhawulo ngenxa yokuthi nami amandla ami aphela la. Because enye into siye sikhale sithi abantu, mhlawumbe uthole ukuthi umuntu uzothi hey, bengihlala kaNongcebo ngoba nakho kuye nongifundisayo, ngoba nakho kungena abazali, kodwa indlela bengihlukumeza ngayo. Kanti wena Nongcebo ukhiphela le ntukuthelo yokuthi hey, bengifuna ukuyithengela imoto entsha, ngikwazi nokuthi ngiyithengela imoto entsha, ngoba nakho uyakwenza yebo, kodwa unayo into ethi kukhona la ke manje sengincishe kakhulu. I mean, leso sibhongo usikhiphe, usikhiphele kuyena lowo muntu. So
isibhongo, that's the word, isibhongo. Resentment, isibu.
So
that's the one. And also it's because sometimes we inherit responsibility and it's so situational. There's nothing that now as Nongcebo can do at that point in time. But uphele 10 years, uphele 20 years, ustuck mhlawumbe nengane kadadewini. And no one in the family has asked you if you are coping or not.
Even just emotionally.
Yes, kodwa fanele lo muntu adle, agqoke, aye esikoleni, abe nama hobbies or whatever the case may be. And kuvele wena nje namhlanje njoba ku whatever day it is. It's Wednesday today. By next week Monday, usune ingane that you're taking responsibility for.
Yeah.
Awuplananga, none whatsoever. And you take it because it's isimo siyaphoqa. But what causes resentment, sometimes it's not even isimo. Because even if I want to be afford, there's someone in one of the stories who says in his real life, uthi Ndumi, I'm not poor. Nginayimali, comfortable, uhlala in estate, is popping, you know, exact job in sensing and so on. He says, kodwa, the 2.5 million that I could calculate that I've paid towards irresponsibility of my parents and my siblings, bishada, iy'ngane zabo, uhlala noma wami, kwanjani, kwanjani, kwanjani. It's the resentment is about ukuthi no one protected me. No one actually said, I wonder how he feels. And the interesting thing about that is that yena, all his life, he thought if I knew about someone else, ozomzwela. What I'm proposing is that asizizweletin. You must do the feeling and say, this feels uncomfortable, ke manje. Let me put it on the table with my siblings and with whoever. Okay, njengoba mina ngikhokha u-5,000 rand every month, izingane zenu zihleli noma. Sekuqala ukungisinda. Singamisa kanjani ukuthi mina ngaqhubeka ngikhokhele uma, bese mhlawumbe mina niyathophapha-ke imali yokuthi yabona ukudla mhlawumbe ngizokukhava, kodwa khona omunye ongangisiza ngokunye. And the sad thing about him is that when he stopped, though this is not appearing in the story, in real life, when he stopped about 5 years ago, 2017, 2018, he stopped paying money because his parents had long passed and so on. But we born ukuthi use umkhulu obhadala black tax, kade aqala ukubhadala black tax esetheshiyana. Use umkhulu ngoba manje is approaching retirement. And the issue yakhe was this. When he stopped, the relationship with his siblings, yaphela. And what that tells us is that vele this the mali iyona ebekuyi glue that was keeping the activity that made this family look like they are together. As soon as esebeka ukuthi hayi madoda ngicela ukudlulisa ibaton komunye umuntu, kwashabalala. So the risk that we are taking by not talking about the black tax, by not talking about our issues as the mali emdenini, is that we are building up this resentment. And we are creating ama families that are based on false pretenses, or families that are based on money as an agent that facilitates family and family activity. And what I'm proposing is that what if we considered transparency, honesty, love, and compassion? Using your black text, details, our anzim, kodwa, siyenze lovingly, siyenze compassionately. But siba conscious about it. Singa yenzi nje in reaction, singa alwi. Ngoba masiyenza ngokulwa, then it means we are dismantling a structure someday. Yabo. So these, the issues are layered. It issue, you layer upon layer. Kodwa the reason why it piles up, nondebo, it is because leyo kala vele ukuthi asiqoxe yona isibangela lezi nkinga esibhekene nazo.
I hope that what people will take away from your book is not just how to themselves handle black text like a pro, but also how to handle their expectation of black text from someone. Because ngingakhuluma nawe lovingly and compassionately ngikuchazela ukuthi anginayo imali. Ungiphendule uthi vele ungcono, vele nje uzenza ungcono. Selokho nje wahamba wayohlala komathekwini, hayi utshela ungcono, hayi ke sikufisela inhlanhla kube ngcono nomphelo. Kanti nami umuntu engimtshelayo kufanele abe nayo icompassion yokuthi kakade phela nasethekwini ave bakithi iya ikhiwa ngamahalavu. And I hope that people will take that away also from the book, not just people who are subjected to black text, but people who are recipients of black text will take into cognizance ukuthi yebo idingo unazo, yebo nawe umuntu uyafisa ukuthi uloko okudingayo nawe ukuthole, kodwa lo muntu oncike kuyena noma othembele kuyena, angathoncike othembele kuyena ukuthi makakulekelele, naye ngeke akwazi ukuthi afinyelele kona konke. Uma kuwukuthi uthi akasafinyeleli kuloko, akusho ukuthi akakuthandi, akusho ukuthi uyakulahla, akusho ukuthi akakufuni, kusho ukuthi amandla angenawo ukuthi akwenzeke lokho.
Yeah, and on that note, Nongcebo, I'd like to read a quote from Dr. Jaya John. It's on page 7 of the book. And this explanation, yama boundaries, we chaza, unfortunately it's in English, kodwa ke, I'll read it slowly so that I express and I'm fully. Uthi, your boundary need not be an angry electric fence that shocks those who touch it. It can be a consistency of light around you that announces, I will be treated sacredly. So I'll read it again. Your boundary need not be an angry electric fence that shocks those who touch it. It can be a consistency of light around you that announces, I will be treated sacredly. And to your point, if you want to be treated sacredly, it is only natural that you want and wish to treat other people and their boundaries sacredly.
Ndumi, thank you so much.
Thank you. Ngiyabonga kakhulu, sis.
And thank you for listening to this episode of the podcast. Remember, you can like, rate, and share this podcast from the channel you're listening on.